this is your boys 11-12-50 backstroke. Your meet record in this event, JD Hafner from Newington, set last year in a time of 28.26. In this heat, heat one, we have David Bounds from Pine Forest in lane two, Robert Mastriani from from Pine Forest in lane three, and in lane four, Shadowmoth Riker Grossis. Taking that heat from lane two was David Bounds from Fort Johnson. Shaving a good bit off the seat time.
During our smaller delay earlier, I was thinking if the kids were over at the concession stand. James, when you were swimming, did you like to race on an empty stomach or full stomach, or it didn't matter?
I was one of those kids who got really nervous before races, so I had to be very selective. Yeah, I usually gotta have something. This is heat two of your boys' 50-yard backstroke. In lane two, we have Horace Norvell from Country Club. In lane three, from Shadow Moss, Dylan Moffitt. In lane four, from Crowfield, Cole Seedorf. And in lane five, from Somerville Y, Mark Wimberly.
Going back to our sponsors, Low Country Women Specialist. Low Country Women Specialist offers the care you need for all your life. As your healthcare needs change over time, we are here for you. Visit us today at one of our two convenient locations in Charleston and Somerville, or find out more at lowcountrywomen.com.
As we finish this heat, that was lane four, Cole Seedorf, taking the comeback win on a good finish there.
There's that good finish on backstroke, and down at the other end, I think one swimmer had a kind of a tight turn, and that does happen. A lot of nerves at City Meet. Maybe kids are forgetting their stroke count. So
I always had trouble with the walls of this pool when I swam here. They're a little bit different than you'll find at most pools. This is heat three. In lane one, we have Max Tippy from Northbridge Terrace, a 9-year-old swimming up today. That's very impressive. In lane two, Hunter Javier from Ashboro in lane two. Again, I'm very sorry, Hunter. In lane three, from Longpoint, Holman Blake. In lane four, from Newington, Ward Crosby. In five, from Somerville Y, Andrew Clark. And in six, from Northbridge, Emmett Reardon.
Max Tippy, that 9-year-old here in lane one, he actually slipped badly off the blocks, but he looks great right now. And he might win this, he might take this heat. Check this out, outside smoke in lane one, and Max wins it in 40.02. It's a drop of some 3 seconds.
These touch pads are slippery. They did have a time in warm-up where you could get back and in practice, but again, it still is slippery. You got to get that just right foot placement. But good recovery off him in lane one from that heat.
Especially swimming in the older age group, that could definitely derail your race if you're a little nervous about your competition. All right, this is heat four. In lane one, we have Evan Astle from Fort Johnston. In two, Tyler Stamen from Crowfield. In three, from Park Shore, Michael Polo. In four, from Duke West, Justinian Murphy Abbott. In lane five, Kusaw, Ben Swetke. And
James, I'd like to add to your strengths, in addition to breaststroke, is pronouncing all these last names. I have looked at a heat sheet and I would have butchered them. Nice job.
Something I really strive for.
James has apparently improved greatly.
Tyler Stamen taking that race from lane two. the CCA, they have a, they still, the old rule was that you could false start once and still be okay. In FINA and USA Swimming, they've taken that rule out. You don't hit the mulligan, but still in the CCA, you get to make a mistake, which is good.
Definitely appropriate for this level of competition. To give them a chance, especially for these younger swimmers.
This is heat five. In lane one, we have Will Cumby from Ashboro. In two, from Shyamalan, Joshua Barty. In three, from Daniel Island, Carlisle Stanley. In four, from Legend Oaks, Logan Southern. In five, from Country Club, Matthew Fortson. And in six, from Sea Farm, Asher Huggins. As we see Carlisle Stanley taking the win there in a time of 35-24.
Something I was just noticing is how some teams have the swimmer's last name on their caps. Other teams don't. Makes me think of basketball, college basketball. I know some teams do not print those last names. It is a team sport, and other teams do. So any thoughts on that, David, about printing last names on the caps?
No one ever gave me a cap with my name on it.
I have a comment for off air for that.
This is your second to last heat. In the boys' 50 backstroke, in lane one from the bottom of the screen, we have Jamison Golden of Hopcaw. In lane two, his teammate Colby Schreier. In lane three, from Sea Farm, Jackson Blankenship. In four, from James Island, Christopher Thomas. In five, from Legend Oaks, Wyatt Mizell. And in lane six, from Shyamalan, Mason Scott. Blankenship with a body length lead here.
Big St. Limbs for Sea Farm tonight. Look at that time, 32.85. Win. 32.85, his entry time was 33.53, so a big drop there.
As we hear the familiar chorus of Sneak Farm coaches behind us.
Hey, every year we end up in the position right next to Sneak Farm. Mm-hmm. Every year.
They are very loud for their swimmers, very supportive. This is your seventh and final heat of boys 50-yard backstroke. In lane one from Long Point, we have Stephen Russell. In lane two, Jacob Hills from Dunes West. In lane three, from Newington, Matthew Phillips. In four, from Cusaw, Jack Jonas. In five, from Daniel Island, Matthew Doty. And in lane six, Larry Underfield from James Island, Wells Fowler.
Matthew Phillips, look at this. Newington trying to get a win tonight. Just 11 in a heat of mostly 12-year-olds. And Jack Matthew Phillips will win it in 30.55. Second place with a 31.64 for Jack Jonas.
Appreciate it.